very, very masarap. Very masarap. What makes Food Prints so special to me? It's not just traveling to interesting places or discovering the most amazing food finds. It's also about the chance to meet with people you wouldn't have crossed paths with otherwise.
How do I describe this group? May shoppingera, may vegetarian, may alaskador, may precise oras, mayroon laging late, mayroon mahilig bumili ng mga maleta kung ano. Mayroon iba, mga impulsive buyer. Mayroon photographer. Nakakatawa yung mix ng group na ito. But you know what? We all get along together. You know why? Common denominator, mahilig lahat kumain.
Unfortunately, we can't keep eating 24/7. So after I brought the group to Fukuoka's Tenjin area for some leisurely shopping, I headed straight to the JTB Tourist Center to check if everything in our itinerary is set. Of course it was. Tours are, after all, their specialty. When I put this tour together with JTB, I personally handpicked the gastronomic, sightseeing, and shopping adventures I wanted my guests to experience. And JTB found a way to arrange it all into a stress-free, minute-by-minute, no-time-wasted itinerary.
This trip became so much more convenient because of the help of JTB. Talagang madaling-madali. All we had to do is board a bus and go wherever we went. Everything was pre-arranged, reservations, lahat time. Basta importante dito, oras.
Want to go to 3 different cities in Japan? Check. Want a hassle-free way to check in and out of different hotels? Check. Money exchange, ticket bookings, airport transfers, luggage transfers, last-minute gift items, double check. It's also nice to just hang out here and take advantage of their free Wi-Fi, use of their PCs, and access to their guidebooks. Plus, you won't leave the place without learning a quirky thing or two about Japan. So if eating is what brings this ragtag group of foodies together, JTB and I thought of a very interesting bonding activity to try this afternoon.
We're at the outskirts of Fukuoka. These are farmlands here. And I brought the group. We're going to go strawberry picking. So the strawberries, by the way, are delicious. They're so juicy. They're huge. They're plump. And I am told that's what we're going to have here. So we're just going to go strawberry picking, and we can eat it while we're doing that. Come on.
Did you notice that it had started raining? That wasn't a problem because guess what? We had umbrellas provided to us. See what I mean about hassle-free? Thanks, JTB.
You know what happened here? After our yung lunch in the marketplace, eh parang may lull before the shopping, no? So I thought, let's do some activity. Anong fruits available? One time we went cherry picking, the other time we went persimmon picking. This time we're going through a strawberry fields na temperature controlled. So this, I'm told, is all year round. Galing!
Fukuoka is famous for sweet and succulent strawberries, so even after a hefty lunch, we all became willing participants in a 30-minute eat-all-you-can smorgasbord at the Nakano Fruit Farm.
The strawberries, as you can see, are in different phases of growth. No? Some of them are still green, the others naman are plump red already, pero malalaki.
A 5-minute tutorial teaches us the right way of picking organic Amao strawberries, which are Fukuoka's prefectural brand.
That's the way to pick it. Actually, yung strawberry doesn't really matter. The size really doesn't matter. What you look for is the color. And what you do is you pick it up with the stem. You just remove the green part. Bite from here. Grabe, tamis and juicy. Iba talaga strawberries dito.
Want to go strawberry picking? Here are some of the things you have to keep in mind. Number one, try to come in the morning when the strawberries are at their freshest. Number two, wear comfortable shoes and clothes. Wear layers in the cold months so that you can remove outer layers easily inside the warm greenhouses. Number three, the farm will give you a cup to throw food waste in. Don't litter. Number four, don't leave strawberries half eaten. That's just a no-no. Number five, eat the strawberries only inside the greenhouses. A separate fee will be charged for takeout.
My God, this is the best!
What?
Oh no, it's so sweet! And then it's eat all you can! Oh no!
You say that now, Ro, but you're going to have another favorite part of the tour in just a few minutes.
This is one of the highlights of the tour, no? I purposely made it very relaxing. It's all food trip and shopping. So this is one of the best outlet stores in the entire Japan. Come. Ito na. Alam mo, grabe mahahanap mo dito. Unbelievable. Friends of mine who love golf, ang mura ng golf clubs dito at saka mga sapatos. Ooh.
Another thing I warned the group about at the start of the tour, take it easy with shopping because you're going to want to spend your money in this place.
This is the Tosu Premium Outlets. Here, what I do here is I go to each shop all over. Siguro take me about an hour and then I choose what I want. Then binabalikan ko yun. Then I pick it out. Tara!
Doesn't love a good outlet mall? Tosu is a great mix of over 150 designer Western brands and local Japanese shops, all at reduced prices.
Here, yung earphones I got before, Manila mga 6,000 pesos, 2,500. I try not to be an impulse buyer, so I go around, I think about it, I pray about it, and then if I decided gusto ko yan, mamalalaman mo eh. If you really want to buy it, then babalikan ko yun.
Here's a hot tip. If you bring your passport with you, you can qualify for tax-free shopping as well. Sweet!
I'm done with my shopping. Now, like I mentioned, I've designed this tour to be very, very relaxing. We had a brunch at the seafood market. Tapos we have the strawberry picking. Now, shopping. Then we're on our way to dinner naman. Saba dinner, yung grilled mackerel. Nasaan na kaya yung mga kasama ko rito? Wala pa. Sa shopping pa yun.